Hello, my name is Paul Bevan from Siemens Digital Industry Software. And in this short demonstration, we're going to take a look at an enhancement to Bridge Surface in the June 2023 release of NX. Currently in the graphics window, you can see the base shape for an electric shower cover. But I want to add some more aesthetic interest into the shape. So I want to create a depression. Now I already have the floor of the depression defined, and I've matched the start of it with curvature continuity to the top face of the shower cover. And you can see this when I activate the reflection line analysis. Now I need to create the transition surface between the rest of the depression and the top face of the shower cover. And to do that, we're going to use Bridge Surface. Now I'm going to start the process by bringing back a projected curve that defines the boundary of the transition surface on the top face. So I'll go ahead and activate the Bridge Surface command. And the enhancement we've made in the June 2023 release for Bridge Surface is that we can now use curve geometry as well as edges to define the bridge surface. But not only that, users can specify continuity constraints if the input curves were created in relation to a support surface, like curve and surface, isoparameter, offset curve on face, or in our case, a projected curve. So my projected curve will be input 1, and the edge of the depression floor will be input 2. The surface is created. I can then define the continuity. I'm going to start off with a position continuity. So I'm just going to zoom in a little closer and then take a look at the edge continuity. First one we'll take a look at is the projected curve. And because it has the supporting surface, it takes the parameters from that supporting surface and matches it in tangency or curvature, depending on what you want. Again, with edge 2, we'll take a look at the continuity there and again make that curvature continuous as well. Once we're happy with it, we can apply the command. We'll take a look at the reflection lines, select that extra face there. We've got some nice smooth transitions. I'm happy with that, so we can move on to the next phase of the process. And that's to sew the two surfaces together. So I select both of those faces, apply the sew command. They're now one sheet body. And now I can simply patch that sheet body into my original shower cover to create the depression. So let's get a better look at the depression. I'm going to hide the projected curve. I'm going to remove the translucency from the shower cover and hide the face edges. And you can see how we have a really nice smooth transition between that depression and the rest of the shower body. If we go back to our reflection lines again, you can see the smooth transition. So let's just recap what you've seen. We started off with the base shape for a shower cover. We already had the base surface or the floor of a depression created. We then utilized the enhanced bridge surface command in the June 2023 release of NX that enabled me to pick curves as one of the input for the bridge surface. And because the projected curve I selected had an underlying supporting surface, the resulting bridge surface uses it to control the edge continuity. Finally, I sewed the two sheet bodies together and patched them into the original shower case body to form the depression. I'd like to thank you for your time and attention.